हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण। सो विल बिगिन। ओम अज्ञान्ति मिरन्दस्य ज्ञानांजना शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वंदेहम श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतः पदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातां सहगणा रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सहगना ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च। नमो ओम विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी इति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्तदेशतारिणे वंचाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यश्च च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामो हरे राम राम रामो हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा। सो वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू ऑल फॉर आर हरिनाम चिंतामणि क्लास। सो लास्ट टाइम वी वर रीडिंग फ्रॉम द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द बुक। So this is, the introduction is by Bhaktivinoda Thakur himself. So in the introduction, Bhaktivinoda Thakur had begun to explain the life of Haridas Thakur. So that's where we had stopped last time. So we'll continue from there. So so basically, just a recap of what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is explaining here. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains that Haridas Thakur was born in a Muslim family and he was actually born in a place in Bangladesh called Budan district. So from Budan, Haridas Thakur came to Benapol. This is also in Bangladesh. And he was chanting throughout the day, throughout the night. And that is the place where Ramachandra Khan, one envious person, an envious Hindu, sends a prostitute called Laksha Hira to allure Haridas Thakur. And Haridas Thakur makes this prostitute into a Vaishnava, offers that cottage to Laksha Hira, and Haridas moves on. So from Budan district, he comes to Benapol, and from Benapol, he comes to Saptagram. Saptagram is in West Bengal. This is the house of Hiranya Majumdar and Govardhan Majumdar, the father and uncle of Raghunath Das Goswami. And there Haridas Thakur stays with Yadunandan Acharya. So Yadunandan Acharya is also one great Vaishnava. So Haridas Thakur stays with him. And this is the place where Haridas would regularly give pravachan on the holy name, the glories of the holy name. And in one particular pravachan, there was one Brahmana called Gopal Chakravarti. So this particular Brahmana, when Haridas Thakur is giving his pravachan, Haridas Thakur says that the holy name is so powerful that just by the glimpse of the holy name, just by the shadow of the holy name, one can get mukti, liberation. That means bhukti is just byproduct of chanting. So this brahmana gets very offended. Mukti, which is considered to be the highest thing, now Haridas Thakur is saying that mukti is just byproduct of chanting. And Gopal Chakravarti, this brahmana, gets very offensive to Haridas Thakur, and he blasphemes Haridas Thakur. So Haridas Thakur leaves that place also. He leaves Saptagram and then continues. So this has been the life of Haridas, not attached to any place, just chanting the names of Krishna. He continues on and on. The Bhagavatam first canto explains the life of Narad Muni. In his previous life, when Narad Muni was the son of the maid servant, so when Narad Muni met these great souls, Bhakti Vedantas, and when his mother, the only mother of Narad Muni, died, so Narad Muni, just chanting the names of Krishna, travels around the globe, completely detached. So this is the life of a Paramahamsa, just traveling and depending on Krishna. So in this way, Haridas Thakur leaves Saptagram and comes to Fuliagram. Fuliagram is also in Bengal. These places are still there. And he comes and stays with Advaita Acharya. Among the Panchatattva, Advaita Acharya is one prominent personality. So Haridas Thakur stays with Advaita Acharya. So this is where we had stopped last time. So we'll continue from here. Haridas left that place, took shelter of Advaita Prabhu in Fuliagram, made his home in a cave by the Ganga's bank, and engaged in Nirjan Bhajan. So Haridas Thakur made his house very close to the house of Advaita Acharya. In a cave, Haridas Thakur was staying. Thinking his personal fame and glory unimportant, a devotee may leave the association of people in general and live like a hermit, but the glory of a devotee can never really be hidden. So even though Haridas was not at all interested in name and fame, he just stayed in a cave there, completely unknown to people, but the glory of a devotee cannot be hidden. Just like if there is a jewel, how much ever you try to cover it with cloth, still it shines. So even though Haridas was running away from name and fame, Krishna wanted to give name and fame to Haridas Thakur. In this way, Haridas's fame and glory became widespread. Hearing of it, the Muslims became angry. So we know the story that Haridas became so famous, even though he didn't want fame. So in Udupi, Pejavar Maharaj, he had given this example that Krishna is like that fountain. What Krishna does, devotees who are humble, Krishna throws them on top. So because Haridas literally didn't want name and fame, Krishna gave so much name and fame to Haridas that all the Muslims became angry, because Haridas was born in a Muslim family. So all the Muslims were thinking, why is not chanting the name of Allah? Why is chanting the name of Krishna? The Muslim king of that place had Haridas arrested and made him suffer. So we know that Haridas was arrested, beaten in 22 marketplaces. He was tried to be tortured in so many ways. Haridas was filled with mercy for every living being. Not considering others' fault, he gave blessings to everyone. So Haridas is such a great soul that people who were beating Haridas, Haridas was praying for them. In fact, the Chaitanya Charitamrita explains that Krishna had actually sent the Sudarshan Chakra to kill these people. But Haridas had so much forgiveness. He was praying to the Lord that please forgive them. The Sudarshan Chakra couldn't work. It was there, but it couldn't act, because the power of Haridas's forgiveness was more powerful than the Sudarshan Chakra. So Haridas was just filled with mercy for every living being. Leaving that place, he returned to his cave. So again, Haridas comes back to his cave. A few days later, Lord Chaitanya came to that place. In Lord Advaita's company, Haridas met Lord Chaitanya and took shelter at his feet. So it is explained that Lord Chaitanya also comes to this cave, and along with Advaita Acharya, Haridas takes shelter of Lord Chaitanya. From that time on, Lord Chaitanya engaged Haridas in preaching the glories of the holy name. So from that point on, Lord Chaitanya told Haridas Thakur that you spread the holy name around. So we know this famous story also, that Lord Chaitanya orders Nityanand Prabhu and Haridas Thakur, go to every house, knock on every door, and tell them to chant the holy names of Krishna. So who is Haridas Thakur? Haridas Thakur is Lord Brahma himself. And who is Nityanand Prabhu? Nityanand Prabhu is Balaram ji. But these two personalities are going house to house, just like devotees go house to house doing book distribution. So the first original book distribution, house to house Sankirtan, was started by Haridas Thakur and Nityanand Prabhu. From that time on, Lord Chaitanya engaged Haridas in preaching the glories of the holy name. When Lord Chaitanya went to Jagannath Puri, Haridas followed and lived by a Siddha Bakul tree. So when Lord Chaitanya took sannyas and came from Navadvip to Jagannath Puri, Haridas also followed Lord Chaitanya. And very close to the residence of Lord Chaitanya stayed in Jagannath Puri in a place called Gambira. Very close to that is a place called Siddha Bakul. It's a Bakul tree. Below that tree, Haridas would sit and chant. When Haridas left this world, Lord Chaitanya personally placed him in a samadhi by the seashore and personally performed his funeral, sankirtan and festival. So Lord Chaitanya had such love for Haridas that Haridas, when he departed from this world, so just like, you know, yesterday was Makar Sankranti. So on the day of Makar Sankranti, Bhishma Dev departs. Uttarayan, you know, Bhishma Dev waits for Uttarayan and then he departs. So the way Bhishma Dev departs, all the devotees of the Lord are there, the Pandavas are there, all the great souls, Vyasadev, Vashishta, Vishwamitra, Shukadev, practically everyone is there, Narad Muni. So all the devotees are there, Lord Krishna is there. So Bhishma Dev, looking at the face of Krishna, chanting the names of Krishna, he departs. Similarly, it was the departure of Haridas Thakur. So when Lord Chaitanya comes to meet Haridas Thakur, Haridas Thakur keeps the feet of Lord Chaitanya in his chest, looking at the face of Lord Chaitanya, while chanting the holy names, along with devotees who are chanting the holy names, Haridas departs. And after Haridas departs, the Lord himself does the final rites of Haridas Thakur. So Lord Chaitanya carries Haridas Thakur and dances around Jagannath Puri. Can you imagine? The Lord is carrying his devotee. And the Lord personally makes the Samadhi of Haridas Thakur. Next to the seashore in Jagannath Puri is the Samadhi Mandir of Haridas Thakur. The devotees, the Lord himself personally dug that ground, placed the body of Haridas Thakur, placed the prasad of Jagannath, the remnants of Jagannath, and then put sand. And then the Lord observed a great festival. Because when the Vaishnavas depart, it is a sad occasion and it is also a glorious occasion. Because now that Vaishnava has gone to the spiritual world. So the Lord has so much love for Haridas Thakur. The devotees who associated with Lord Chaitanya in his pastimes became very devoted to him. By his order, they preached his teachings to the world. Asking of him some questions, Lord Chaitanya made the truth of the holy name appear from Haridas's mouth. So, just like I told you, the Lord loves to give credit to his devotees. So in this book, Lord Chaitanya is asking Haridas Thakur questions about the glories of the holy name and Haridas Thakur is answering so that the glories of Haridas Thakur becomes more famous. These teachings are described in many places in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Sri Chaitanya Bhagavat and in many other books describing devotional service. So the teachings of the discussion between Haridas and Lord Chaitanya is discussed in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Chaitanya Bhagavat and many other books also. Encouraged at various times by various devotees, I have compiled an anthology of various writings describing Sri Haridas Thakur's preachings about the holy name. So what Bhaktivinoda Thakur has done is, because many devotees were encouraging Bhaktivinoda Thakur to compile these teachings, so Bhaktivinoda Thakur has taken the teachings of Haridas Thakur from various books, from Chaitanya Bhagavat, Chaitanya Charitamrita and many other books and compiled it in this form of this book, Harinam Chintamani. From different faraway places, I have gathered many books about Haridas. So in previous times, when great souls like Bhaktivinoda Thakur would write books, it was not like 1 month affair for them. It would take a lot of research work. So as I told you in one of the class, this book is actually a PhD subject book. Lot of research is gone. Just like we have Nectar of Devotion, Bhakti Rasamrit Sindhu. Rupa Goswami took 17 years to write that book. It's this thin book only. 17 years to write that book. So much compilation has gone. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying that from far away places he has gathered many books on the life of Haridas. Seeing that the statements of the Sahajiyas, Baulas and many others are only incoherent ramblings that have no value, I have taken care to avoid their words. So during Bhaktivinoda Thakur's time, there were many upper sampradayas. Upper sampradayas means people who were claiming themselves to be followers of Lord Chaitanya and Haridas, but they had missed the essence. You know, they had gone through sort of sentimental affair. You know, they were doing all wrong things in the name of Vaishnavism. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur had to get right books, and he had to see that the wrong teachings are not incorporated. So that the pure teachings is kept intact. So that's the contribution of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. In this way, I found one or two books explaining the pure Vaishnava philosophy. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur says he found one or two books which were completely pure. Actually, there were 16 titles in 32 manuscripts, books pleasing to the Rasikas. So he found 16 different titles in 32 different manuscripts. At this, I was very happy. Sri Haridas Thakur taught the glories of the holy name to various pure devotees, and in their Gurudev's name, these disciples wrote various books. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur in his research found out that Haridas Thakur had given the teachings of the holy name to various devotees at various times. And these devotees, their disciples had written books. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur gathered all these books and has compiled the essence in this book, Harinam Chintamani. Seeing these books, the devotees in Sri Hattagram, who had originally encouraged me to write, became very thankful. All these books I found contained Haridas's teachings about the holy name. This book, Harinam Chintamani, is a compilation of those teachings. So this book is a compilation of all those teachings that Bhaktivinoda Thakur found out. To please the devotees whose only wealth is Lord Krishna, I now publish this book. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written this book for devotees whose wealth is only Krishna. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, who should not read this book? I do not think persons who are not devoted to the holy name, persons who do not think Lord Krishna is their only wealth, should read this book. So this book, Bhaktivinoda Thakur makes it very clear, it is not for public. The basis of this book is people who have faith in Krishna and faith in the holy name, they only can appreciate this book. Their appreciation for the holy name can go to the next level. I have no wish to hear foolish arguments of the non-devotees. So those whose basics are clear, they can appreciate this book. So this goes from the understanding that the basics are already clear. You know, so Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, if people have still questions about the basics, then you have to wait to come to this book. So we hope that all the devotees, basics at least clear. There are many paths of sadhana bhakti. So we know that sadhana bhakti has various limbs, Navvidha bhakti, and then in Upadeshamrita, Rupa Goswami gives 64 different limbs of bhakti. Taking shelter of the holy name is one of these paths. So one of the very important aspects of sadhana bhakti, one of the most important limbs is taking shelter of the holy name. From the time of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the exalted devotees have followed this path, which was taught by Sri Haridas Thakur. So from the time of Lord Chaitanya, devotees have always been taking shelter of the holy name. For a long time, the devotees residing in Vraja forests have followed this path, and starting a few days before them, the Bhajanandi Vaishnavas in Jagannath Puri have also followed it. So this is the process that, you know, great souls who go to Vrindavan and take shelter of Vrindavan, or those who even go to Jagannath Puri and take the vow of Bhajanandi. So there are two categories of devotees. One is called the Goshtanandis, one who preach the glories of Krishna and the holy names. And the other is the Bhajanandis, those who prefer to stay in seclusion and do their own bhajan on their own. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, so because Bhaktivinoda Thakur had studied the life of these Bhajanandis in Vrindavan and in Jagannath Puri, so Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, I have seen with my own eyes. So he says, with my own eyes, I have seen how they follow. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, I have seen with my own eyes how the Babajis follow the vow of chanting the holy name. At the end of their Shri Hari Bhakti Vilas, Shri Sanatan Goswami and Shri Gopala Bhatta Goswami clearly wrote about this method of performing pure devotional service, a method that consists of living in a solitary place and always hearing, chanting and remembering the holy name without offense. So Sanatan Goswami along with Gopala Bhatta Goswami have compiled a book called Hari Bhakti Vilas. So just like Rupa Goswami compiled Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, similarly Sanatan Goswami has also compiled Hari Bhakti Vilas, which contains more details also. So in that book, they explain how someone who practices the path of Bhajanandi, he sits in a solitary place. This is called Nirjan Bhajan. Now, without any interaction with people, they sit in a solitary place and hear and chant. In fact, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also, towards the end of his life, he took Babaji Vesh. And in Jagannath Puri, he was sitting and continuously hearing and chanting. This Shri Harinam Chintamani is written in the meter Payar. Women, children, and persons unlettered in Sanskrit can easily learn Lord Chaitanya's teachings from it. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written this book in simple Bengali. So as we discussed, he's not incorporated Sanskrit verses in it, so that even people who have no knowledge of Sanskrit, the simple children, women, all of them can also appreciate the essence of the teachings of Lord Chaitanya. In this book, I have not placed any Sanskrit quotes, for that might trouble them. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is so sensitive that people should get the essence. If I put too much Sanskrit, then it might put off devotees. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur has kept it very, very simple. Other books have already woven a great garland of scriptural quotes about the holy name. So there are many other Vaishnava books which contain many, many scriptural quotes, Sanskrit quotes about the holy name. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur has not quoted any Sanskrit here. Harinam Chintamani follows the statements of all those scriptural quotes. So even though there is no Sanskrit verses here, one should not think that Bhaktivinoda Thakur is writing is something of his own. No. Each of the Bengali verses that Bhaktivinoda Thakur quotes has Sanskrit references. He's just made it into simple language. That's all. If Lord Krishna wills, may this book be promptly published for the benefit of devotees. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote this book somewhere in the 1800s. No. So much endeavor is gone. So these are great souls who see what Radhana Maharaj was once explaining. What is service? Service means to create facility before the need arises. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur in 1980s, he knew that in future the need will arise. There will be ISKCON centers, there will be devotees who will be chanting and they will need this book. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur at that time did this service for all of us. So by reading this book, we get this connection. We can better appreciate Lord Chaitanya, Haridas Thakur, and we can also appreciate this personality of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So when we read the teachings of our own acharyas, that's how we appreciate them. Many times the disciples would come to Srila Prabhupada and ask Srila Prabhupada, Prabhupada, can you answer my question? Prabhupada would tell them, don't keep coming and troubling me. Whatever I have to tell you, I have written in my books. Please read my books. So these great acharyas, we can appreciate them. We can actually understand them when we read their books. Now they have put a lot of energy in making these books. So this was the introduction by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So till now we saw the foreword by Sachinandan Swami. We saw the preface by Sarvashakshi Prabhu, who's compiled this book. Introduction by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, the original author of this book. And now, before we get into chapter 1, there is prologue by another devotee, Yashomati Devi Mataji. So we'll read this prologue. All glories to His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, who introduced the chanting of the Lord's holy name in every town and village around the world. So just like we have to be grateful to Haridas Thakur for giving us these teachings, to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we have to be much more grateful to Srila Prabhupada. Because if it was not for Srila Prabhupada, this book wouldn't be in our hand. We wouldn't know who is Bhaktivinoda Thakur, who is Haridas Thakur, what is the holy name, we don't know anything. So the contribution of Prabhupada is, Prabhupada has made the chanting of the holy name in every town and village. Prithvite ache yata nagar adi gram sarvatra prachar hoibe mora naam. Lord Chaitanya predicted that my name, the names of Krishna, will be chanted in every town and village around the world. Till Srila Prabhupada came, no one had faith that it actually literally meant around the world. So people, all the Gaudiya Vaishnavas are thinking, around the world means Lord Chaitanya meant every town and village around Bengal. They couldn't even imagine around India. But Prabhupada had faith in the words of Lord Chaitanya and he took it to every town and village around the world. So now Hare Krishna is such a common thing, practically everyone knows it. You know, the holy name has been chanted practically everywhere. That credit goes to Srila Prabhupada. So Haridas Thakur is great, but for us, Srila Prabhupada is that greatest teacher who has actually introduced chanting everywhere. Congratulations to all the readers. So congratulations to all of you all. Why? You have in your hand a rare and most precious treasure, a sincere Harinam Sadhaka's guidebook for attaining love of God, Sri Harinam Chintamani. So as Bhaktivinoda Thakur also explained, that this is not an ordinary book. So this book is a great treasure. So from the treasure house of Krishna, this book has come. Because by reading this book, anyone who wants to become better in chanting the holy names, Harinam, this book is the guidebook. How to attain love of Godhead. How to attain Krishna Prem, this is the guidebook. It is an invaluable legacy and birthright of the Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya, gifted by a most revered and merciful predecessor Acharya, Srila Sachinandan Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So this is our legacy. Our legacy of our Gaudiya Sampradaya is these books and the holy name. Just like, you know, every family or every business has its own legacy. Every nation has its own legacy. So our legacy is this book. And this is the birthright of every Gaudiya Vaishnava. And this has been gifted by Srila Sachinananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This is a gift that Bhaktivinoda Thakur has given all of us. How may the conditioned souls be easily delivered from their suffering? It is in answer to this succinct and deep question from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that Namacharya Srila Haridas Thakur summarized the essence of pure chanting. So in Chaitanya Charitamrita, this episode comes. One day Lord Chaitanya asks Haridas Thakur, how will all the conditioned souls be liberated? And there Haridas Thakur begins to explain his teachings to Lord Chaitanya. So based on those teachings of Haridas Thakur, this book is compiled. In Sri Harinam Chintamani, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur takes us on an ethereal journey to witness the conversations between Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Haridas Thakur on the most crucial subject for this age of Kali, the chanting of the holy name, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is taking us on this journey and placing us in front of Lord Chaitanya Haridas Thakur in this conversation. He's actually taking us there, giving us entry, because this is the most crucial subject for the age of Kali. For the age of Kali, discussing on chanting is one of the most crucial things. Because in this age of Kali, no other method works. Everything fails. This is the only thing that is helpful. So that's why this discussion is something that's very, very important to us. Harinama ye jagate dila kripa kari siddhi labe shishta jiva labi ke vari upaya vaila nama shastrira sammatta anya shubha karma madhye vaila ganita. So this is a verse from Harinam Chintamani Adi. O Lord, you mercifully gave the world the holy name of Krishna. Intelligent souls will chant the holy name to attain perfection. The holy name is the primary way to attain perfection. That is the scripture's conclusion. other pious deeds are counted as secondary ways to attain perfection. So this is the essence of all scriptures, which we will see in detail in Harinam Chintamani, that Haridas Thakur is praying to the Lord that, O Lord, you have mercifully given, because of your kripa, you have given all of us chanting of your holy name, because chanting of the holy name is the primary way to achieve perfection. So there is Mukhya Panta, primary way, and Gauna Marga, secondary way. So performing pious deeds, doing karma kanda, yagya, these are secondary ways. Dana, karma, tapa, these are secondary ways. But the primary way of attaining perfection is chanting the holy name. This is the fast track. The other processes for attaining God are slow tracks. They don't have so much power in Kali Yuga. Tara madhye sarva shrestha nama sankirtan nira aparade nama layile paya premadan. So this is from Chaitanya Charitamrita. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu telling Sanatana Goswami. Tara madhye sarva shrestha nama sankirtan. So in Chaitanya Charitamrita, there is Sanatana Shiksha, where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu instructs Sanatana Goswami in detail. Just like we discussed, Sanatana Goswami has compiled this book called Hari Bhakti Vilas, containing the science of bhakti. And Rupa Goswami has compiled a book called Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. So both these, Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, got the teachings from Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya gave Rupa Goswami in a nutshell the understanding, and Sanatana Goswami in a nutshell. So in the teachings to Sanatana Goswami, Lord Chaitanya explains the five primary aspects of bhakti. There are 64 aspects, 64 limbs of bhakti. Out of that, five are most important. Which are they? Nama Sankirtan, chanting the holy names. Bhagavat Shravan, hearing Bhagavatam. Sadhu Sangha, or Vaishnav Seva, associating with devotees. Shri Murti Ra Seva, worshipping deities. And Mathura Vas, going to holy places. These are five most important. But Lord Chaitanya says, out of this five also, Tara Madhye Sarva Shrestha Nama Sankirtan. Out of these five and out of the nine limbs of devotion service, most important is Nama Sankirtan. Of the nine process of devotional service, the most important is to always chant the holy name of the Lord. And how one should chant? If one does so, avoiding the 10 kind of offenses. Nirapadade Nama Laile. If one chants the holy name without offenses, without the 10 offenses. What are the 10 offenses? How to avoid it is the subject matter of this book. What will happen if one chants without offenses? Paya Premadan. One very easily obtains the most valuable love of Godhead. So that Premadan, we are all after wealth. Correct. And ultimately everyone is after love only. That is the ultimate wealth. Because how much ever money you have, if you don't have love, you will not be happy. Isn't it? If you are like the king of the entire world, imagine the entire world belongs to you, but you are the only one person in this world. There is no one else in this world. Not even a bird, not even a butterfly is there. How will you be happy? So wealth doesn't make us happy. What makes us happy is love and relationship. And the ultimate love that we are looking for is Premadhan, that love of Krishna. And that one can get if one chants the holy name without offenses. Just as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu instructed Sri Ramananda Rai and Sri Rupa Goswami to respectively reveal the rasas and their secrets, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya to explain the intricacy of liberation, he wanted Srila Haridas Thakur, Sri Haridas Thakur, born without specific qualifications, to deliver Nama Tattva, the process for this age. So the Lord chooses different devotees to carry out different functions. So the Lord, through Ramananda Rai, who is one of the associates of the Lord, and through Rupa Goswami, revealed rasa, you know, bhakti rasa, the different mellows, shantaras, dasyaras, sakyaras, and their intricacies, the secrets of rasa, is explained by Ramananda Rai and Rupa Goswami. So Ramananda Rai, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is having conversation in Kovur, on the banks of Godavari, and Ramananda Rai. So again, there also Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is asking Ramananda Rai questions and Ramananda Rai is answering. Similarly, Rupa Goswami in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu is a book containing Bhakti Rasa. All the rasas are explained in detail. Similarly, Lord Chaitanya chooses Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, who is also one of the associates of the Lord, to reveal the secrets of liberation. In the same way, Lord Chaitanya chooses Haridas Thakur, who in one sense doesn't have any special qualification. Born in a Muslim family, no understand. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya at least has read the Vedas, understood the Vedas. Haridas Thakur has not done anything. But then Lord Chaitanya chooses Haridas Thakur to deliver Nama Tattva, to teach everyone about the process of the Holy Name. And therefore, he awards Haridas Thakur the title Namacharya. It is our good fortune that Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur compiled these instructions in straightforward language for the benefit of simple-minded Kali Yuga reprobates. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur's greatness is that same teachings of Haridas Thakur of Namacharya is given in a very simple way so that people of Kali Yuga, even though we may not have an understanding of Sanskrit, we can easily understand it. So it's not in a complicated language, it's in a very simple language. This book reveals the glories of the holy names, which is more than a process, as it is also the goal sought. It is both sadhana and sadhya. So this book, which we will see also in the chapters ahead, Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains that the holy name is the goal also and the process also. It is the means also and it is the end also. So someone asked Srila Prabhupada, what is the goal of chanting Hare Krishna? What do you want to achieve by chanting Hare Krishna? Prabhupada said, the only thing that we want to achieve by chanting Hare Krishna is chanting of more Hare Krishna. So it's not that we chant Hare Krishna so that we come to a particular stage and then we stop. No, we chant Hare Krishna so that we can chant more of Hare Krishna. Like Rupa Goswami in his prayer, he prays, my dear Lord, the name Krishna has so much nectar. I mean, for us, this is just a poetic verse, but Rupa Goswami is experiencing this. So he's saying, my dear Lord, your name Krishna, these two syllables, Krishna, has so much nectar that one tongue is not enough. With one tongue, how much I can taste? I desire thousands of tongues. And 2 years are not enough. I want millions of years. And when this holy name enters through my heart in this way, it completely conquers my heart. So, right now we are chanting. For us, chanting is more like a medicine for us right now. We do it because we have to do it. It's not that we want to do it. For most of us, it's that we have to do it. Taken a vow or whatever reason it is. But then when we keep going on like this, we'll come to a stage where from have to, we will want to do it. We will not be able to stop doing it. It will become like an addiction for us. Continuously chanting and chanting. So right now we are in the stage of Namaparad. Then we'll come to the stage of Namabhas. Namaparad is a stage where you chant with offenses. Then the next stage is a stage where you are trying to, Namabhas means basically you are trying to free yourself of offenses. And then finally you come to the stage of Shuddha Nam. That's what our aim is. Just like one time there was a person who never saw gold. So someone told him, you climb the stair and then you will get gold. So this fellow climbed the stair and he went on top and he saw gold everywhere. And then he walked down the stair and he realized that the entire stair also was made of gold only. He just didn't realize it. So similarly, when we chant the holy name, we have to understand that this is the goal also and this is the means also. Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains this science in detail. Through the building of faith and the recognition of avoidance of offense, it offers a systematic procedure to advance from chanting with aparad, cold and heartless, to namabhas, the clearing stage, and finally shuddha nam, the immediate precursor to pure love of God. So in this book, Bhaktivinoda Thakur takes us to this journey where we start with building our faith. So the first stage is chanting with aparadh. So certainly are cold and heartless. We just chant, but then the heart is not involved there. There is no feeling, there is no emotion. You know, just like the Bhagavatam explains, stone-hearted. There are no emotions that come. So through that stage, through that level, we come to the next stage called Namabhas. Namabhas is called the clearing stage. We are trying to get ourselves free from offenses. So at least Namabhas means at least you first become aware that you are doing offenses. When you become aware, first when we understand what the offenses are, where we are doing, so that awareness is important. In the Namaparadh stage, you are doing offenses and you are not even aware that you are doing. But in the Namabhas stage, you are at least aware that you are doing offense and you gradually want to clear it. And then finally, we come to the stage of Shuddha Nam, which is one step before Krishna Prem. That is the journey. Chanting with neither affection nor success is chanting with aparadh. So when we chant and we don't get any success and we don't experience any emotion, it's heartless. So we don't have any emotions that come. That means we are doing aparadh. What does aparadh mean? Upa means without or against, and radh means flow of affection or success. So there are two meanings of the word aparadh. One meaning is aparadh means where Radharani is not there. Bhakti is not there. That's one meaning. Other meaning is radh means flow of affection. So when there is hindrance to the flow of affection, such chanting is called aparadh nam. It is that utterance which is made with enmity in the heart. So when we chant with enmity in the heart, with so much grudges towards others and you know so much anartha that we have, it is aparadh stage. It is that chanting which displeases the holy name. So the holy name is also a person. Nama Prabhu. So not in this book, in another book, Japa book by Gurijantu. So Gurijantu explains how this 10 offenses work. So he explains that just like, you know, if you are working for a particular boss, if you want to please, if there is a very wealthy person, if you want to please him, you are trying to please him and simultaneously there is a servant of that wealthy person, you go and beat that person up. Will that wealthy person be pleased with you? He will not be pleased with you. Or if you are trying to please him and then there is a servant of him who is very dear to this wealthy person, you start to blaspheme him, criticize him, the wealthy person is not pleased. He is not happy. Similarly, if you chant the holy name and when we do all these offenses, the name is not pleased. Nam Prabhu is not pleased and he withdraws the mercy. Mercy doesn't come. We chant, but Krishna doesn't give that mercy. It is against spiritual success. It acts against spiritual success by taking the flow of one's affection away from the Lord. So when we do offense, just like, you know, the holy name, the mercy of the holy name is flowing. Yeah? But rather, that flow is there of the holy name. But then when we put obstacles in it, then that flow is stopped, is choked. Some little mercy may come, but it is choked. So these 10 offenses are like those boulders that stop that flow from coming. So when we remove these offenses, then we will see that there is great success in chanting. Therefore, it should be carefully avoided. The offenses should be carefully avoided. This book is not a dissertation awaiting comments or arguments. So this book is not for arguing, you know. What is mentioned here, is it a fact or not? You know, it's not for that purpose. This book is intended for serious, faithful chanter who is eager to perfect his practices, his sadhana. So this book is, as I told you, it's understood that people have already certain faith in the process of bhakti. You know, some basic understanding of Gita, Bhagavatam is there. And then when we enter this book, and we are serious. So the requirement is, the condition for the candidate is, he has to be serious and a faithful chanter who is really wanting to make his sadhana perfect and is really looking to find out what's wrong in my sadhana. I'm chanting the holy name for so many years. Why am I not experiencing emotion? What's going wrong? He wants to find out those blocks and remove those blocks. It is for such devotees. It is reserved for those who are determined to submissively seek advice with trust from pure spiritual ancestors in learning to serve and love the holy name without motives or attachments. So this book is reserved for those who are determined to submissively seek advice. Those who are determined to achieve Krishna Prem, to better their sadhana and their holy name, and to seek advice. Please tell me what's wrong with me. Just like in vehicles, na? Sometimes at the back of the vehicles they write, please give your comment how my driving is. Similarly, you know, for us the most important driving is chanting. And Haridas Thakur, who is the Namacharya, is ready to give comments, you know, on how we can improve our chanting. So we come in this mode with a lot of submissiveness to hear from Haridas Thakur, with a lot of trust that these people are our well-wishers. Like Srila Prabhupada would sign every letter to every disciple, your ever well-wisher, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami. So these great souls like Haridas Thakur, Bhaktivinoda Thakur are our well-wishers. They actually want us to become better devotees. They want us to move from the stage of Nama Aparad to Nama Amas to Shuddha Nama. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur has put so much effort. Haridas Thakur has given all this because they are filled with compassion in their heart. So for such people who are determined, who are submissive and who trust our spiritual ancestors, who want to chant the holy name with lot of love, without material attachments, this is the book. It has the potential to usher in pure bhakti, prema bhakti. So this book has great potential to bring that flood of Krishna prem in all our lives. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is very clear in his introduction. So we read this para, but we'll just read it because it's coming here. This is not an ordinary book. Again, before we get into chapter 1, this is not an ordinary book, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying. Only persons who have faith in Lord Chaitanya and in devotional service and who take shelter of the holy name are qualified to understand this book. So only people who have faith in Lord Chaitanya, faith in the process of bhakti, and faith in the process of bhakti as taught by Lord Chaitanya, and faith in the process of the holy name can understand this book. I do not think persons who do not think of Lord Krishna as their only wealth should read this book. I have no wish to hear from foolish arguments of the non-devotees. We pray that all sincere students of Sri Harinam Chintamani will daily take advantage of the saintly association provided through this publication. So we are all sincere students trying to understand the holy name from the greatest teacher of the holy name, Namacharya. The greatest teacher of the holy name, Namacharya, is teaching us. For those who are submissive, can take lessons. We are indebted to Sarvasakshi Prabhu and his team for making this complete edition available in English and Hindi. I thought it was only in English, but it's in Hindi also. Someone was asking me yesterday whether this book is in Hindi. It will certainly bring about success in everyone's quest for pure chanting, and all can soon welcome the Lord, chanting constantly on their tongue in all humility along with Srila Haridas Thakur. So if we read this book and understand this book, we all can welcome the Lord. So when we chant the holy name, actually, we need to understand that Krishna is actually coming and dancing on our tongue. We don't have that experience. Even we may theoretically think that Krishna is coming on dancing on our tongue, our understanding is, when will Krishna's dance get over? And when will Krishna go so that I can start my actual dance? Again, that is our stage. But then when we read this book, we can gradually, at least some of the mood and realization of Haridas Thakur may rub on us. Kripa kari naam rupe amara jivaya nirantara nacha prabhu dhari tava paaya. So this is a verse from Harinam Chintamani. Haridas Thakur is saying, Kripa kari naam rupe amara jivaya. O Lord, be merciful and appear on my tongue in the form of your holy name. Please appear on my tongue and dance there constantly. Nirantara nach Prabhu. So Bhakti Haridas Thakur is not saying dance only for 1 hour, 2 hours, not more than that. Baad mein bead bag rakh do, next day. Till then, I don't want to see that bead bag again. So Haridas Thakur is praying, dance there constantly. Nirantara nach Prabhu dhari tava paya. I fall at your lotus feet and beg this of you. So with this, we have ended the prologue, the introduction, the preface, and the foreword of the book. So from next time, we will start chapter 1. We'll be actually getting to the book. So chapter 1 is the glories of the holy name, Shri Nam Mahatmai Suchan. So that we will do from next time. Anyone has any questions, any comments?
Till what? Thank you, Guru. और ये आपका हरि नाम का कीर्तन हमारे पंजाब में पहुंच रहा है, इसके लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। और अच्छा लगा अच्छी क्लास सर।
हरे कृष्ण। किसी का कुछ प्रश्न है ऑफलाइन ऑनलाइन?
एक मेरा क्वेश्चन है। मैं गोपाल जी के लिए फ्रूट लेने गया था, तो मैंने पूछा उससे, फ्रूट वाला था, जैसे कि वो शॉप लगाता हुआ बड़े की, तो मतलब किसके लिए लेके जा रहे, बोलो। तो मैंने बोला कि हमारे गोपाल जी उनका भोग लगाते हैं। तो उसने एक पर्चा दे दिया मेरे को, उसने तो संत रामपाल जी नहीं है जो अभी जेल में बंद है, कबीरदास जी के फैन है वो। तो वो बताने लग गए, फिर वो गीता के मेरे को श्लोक सुनाने लग गया, तो ऐसे लिखा हुआ गीता में। तो मैं बोला को भगवान कौन है फिर? तो संत कबीर को भगवान बता रहे थे और श्री कृष्ण भगवान को बता रहे थे। भोग करने वाले थे, ऐसे करे थे। चलो ठीक है, तो मैं उसको, मैं सोच रहा था उसको भगवत गीता दूं, तो उसको दे सकता हूँ? नहीं,
दीजिए गीता दीजिए उसको।
अगली गीति पढ़ी नहीं होगी ना अभी,
आप गीता दीजिए उसको, अच्छा रहेगा।
थैंक यू, थैंक यू।
एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस? और कुछ प्रश्न आज के विषय में, हरि नाम के विषय में? ठीक है, तो वी विल एंड फॉर टुडे। So we'll end for today. We'll continue from next week. So from next week we will actually start chapter 1. ठीक है, तो जिन भक्तों ने
हरे कृष्ण प्रभु जी, about about Hampi Yatra would like to share with
तो हाँ, तो दो अनाउंसमेंट। पहला, जिन those devotees who have not taken books, please do take books, because this is a study program, so it's not like a lecture, it's a study program, you know. So if you all have books, you all can really appreciate it. So please do take your copy. And I would also advise, instead of sharing books between couples also, if you can have individual books, it's nice. It's nice, you know. Not for promoting our books, but it's good to have your own copy. That's one thing. Second is, as all of you all know, we are going for Hampi Yatra from 10th to 14th Feb. So if you all can come, it's great. We know that the COVID thing is still on, but the COVID thing is going to go on for quite some time now. So if you all can come, most welcome, please do come. So we have spoken to the Kadamba bus, a luxury bus. It's a 40-45 seater bus. So if you get that figure, we will do that bus. Otherwise, plan two is we will all take private vehicles and go, depending on what happens. But it'd be nice if all of you all can come to Hampi. It's been long time that we have gone together, an entire year, and we don't know when we are going to announce the next yatra. So this yatra is there, you all can take advantage of it. So please give your names immediately, so that we are clear whether we have to do the bus, we have to do cars, you know, so that our planning can happen. We have to book hotel rooms also, so we need to get clarity of that also. Okay. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Yes.